today we are going to start a new chapter, that is a staffing, chapter number 6. Staffing is there. Remember, friends, the foundation of any organization is talented and hardworking people. All right. Who are the principal assets of any firm? So the human resource is playing very important role in the case of any organization, and it is you can say it is also deciding the success and failure of any organization, because they are very, very important assets of the organization. So whenever we are talking about staffing, so staffing is playing very important role when we are talking about the human resource. So the first thing is here, what is meaning of staffing? Let's try to understand. Putting people to jobs. So whenever we are putting people on the job, that is meaning of staffing. So we are what we are doing here, we are doing recruitment here, we are doing selection, we are giving them training, we are giving them development, we are giving them promotion, compensation, appraisal of work. All these things are part of staffing. Okay. The managerial function of filling and keeping filled the position in the organization. So this is the meaning of staffing. What is meaning of staffing? Staffing is a function of management, as we know. And what they are doing here, they are filling and keeping. What they are keeping? They are filling and keeping filled the position in the organization. So in organization, we know that we are dividing the work, we are giving authority and responsibility, and many things are there. So in that, we need some human resource to do the work. At that time, the staffing is there. In this staffing process, in this staffing, what we are doing, we are filling that all the places, and we are, when it is filled, we are also keeping them filled. If it is not filled, we are filling it, and after filling, we are keeping them filled all the time, all the position in the organization. So here in staffing, what they are doing, they are trying to identify the what is the requirement of workforce is there, and afterwards what they are plan, they are doing planning according to that. Then they are starting the recruitment process, selection is there, they are providing them training, they are providing them some development, and they are also giving them deciding their compensation, their salary, their promotion, their performance appraisal, and everything and many things are there which are including in staffing process. So here in staffing, what is happening in staffing? Remember, it is a very, very important function of management. And when we talk about the staffing, staffing means what? Staffing means arrangement of manpower, arrangement of human resource. And here we people are trying to get the right type of person on a right job. And this staffing function is seen at all levels of management, whether we are talking about top level, middle level, or lower level. And another thing is there, it is a continuous process. It is not stopping only, because the staffing process is going on continuously, because sometimes we are giving them training throughout the life of the business. So this staffing process is going on continuously. At the same time, this is a human orientation. So here they are trying to develop the people, and why they are trying to develop the people? To get their full potential. So all these things are a part of staffing. Let's try to understand its importance with the help of these points. So first one is what? First one is discovery of competent person. So when we talk about the staffing, at that time, this staffing is helping us to find out the competent staff member or competent employee for the various jobs. And next is improve performance. How we can say it is improving performance? It is improving performance Because we are putting the right person on the right job. That's why we can say it is giving you the higher performance. Next is optimum utilization of the human resource is possible because why it is possible? Because it is avoiding the disturbance of work due to shortage of the employees. So here there is no shortage. Here it is a function of staffing that you must have to keep what he is saying. They are keeping a function of filling and keeping filled. So when it is possible at that time, the optimum utilization is there. Why? Because all the time the place is filled. That's why we can say it is optimum utilization of resources. Next is ensures survival and growth. So if the staffing function is done properly at that time there will be a success of planning. There will be a successful execution of planning is possible, and like that way it will increase our profit and it is in favor of organization, and like that way it is ensuring our survival and growth. Next is improves job satisfaction. Whenever here we can see it is improving the staffing when the right person is on right place at that time, the morale of the employees will be increased, their job satisfaction will be increased, and like that way we can say there he is getting why it is possible, because they are getting the fair reward is there, fair salary they are getting, and it is a responsibility of manager is there, who has to arrange all these things and provide them proper salary and give them job satisfaction. And due to that, what happened? Ultimately, the organization will get the benefit in terms of his efficiency will be increased. All right. I hope you understand, friends. Thank you very much. But before going, if you want to remember all this point, easily one word is there, that is a PDOCS. Let's try to understand what is PDOCS. P means improve performance, D means discovery of competent personnel, O means optimum utilization of resource, G means ensures survival and growth, and S means improves the job satisfactions. I hope you understand, friends. Thank you very much.